here in Koyuk. We left Unalakleet, and Greg and Bruce left Koyuk. They're headed for White Mountain. But that means that Dylan and I get to be here and watch these teams come in. Man, Pete's team looks so nice. Look at that. Really nice movers, really chipper. Came in with lots of good speed and energy into the checkpoint. Nice looking team. Of course, the leaders are going to start wandering around while Peter signs in on the clipboard, as they like to do. Getting around those straw bales looks a bit tricky. It can be so difficult coming into these communities as checkpoints. You know, mushers are dealing with plowed roads, they're dealing with 90 degree corners. That particular corner is like kind of cut out. I think the straw bales are sitting there on the edge to try to give mushers a little something to bump up next to. But it's it can be really, really tricky. It's one of my least favorite parts of this race, actually, is coming in and out of these checkpoints on these plowed roads. Not exactly designed for dog teams. I think that Pete's gonna park. Just picking a spot. What do you see, Dylan?
I just saw him put a snow hook in.
All right. Pete Kaiser into Koyuk. Pete Kaiser will sometimes jump these checkpoints here on the coast at the end to try to gain a competitive advantage, but I think if Pete was going to do that, we would have seen him grab his drop bags and some straw right there when he checked in, and he did not do that. So Pete must be staying here for at least a little while in Koyuk.
And it looks like the next musher will be Amanda Otto.
All right, fantastic.
I don't think they could hear me spit out.
Let me get a little time reference for myself.
Pete, hop in front of the camera. Let's be like, guys, we're in Koyuk.
Yeah. Pete Kaiser in at 6:55. The ninth musher into Koyuk.
Okay. Thank you.
back over there?
I won't worry about it.